Hi, and welcome to my abstract presentation entitled Segmentation of Retinal Low-Cost Optical Coherence Tomography Images Using Deep Learning. My name is Timo Kepp. I am a PhD student at the Institute of Medical Informatics at the University of Lübeck. This work was originally presented at this year's SPE Medical Imaging Conference in Houston, and is a joint work with the Medical Laser Center in Lübeck and the Department of Ophthalmology at the University of Kiel. The age-related macular degeneration, abbreviated AMD, is the leading cause for blindness in developed countries. AMD damages the macular lutea, which is the central part of the retina, and contains the highest density of rods. Thus, damage causes loss of the central and sharp vision, which is important for everyday life. The AMD has two forms: the dry and the wet AMD. The dry AMD affects about 70 to 80% of all AMD patients and has a rather slow disease progression, whereas small deposits accumulate within the retina, which are called drusen. In contrast, the wet AMD affects only 10 to 15% of AMD patients, but accounts for 90% of all cases with severe vision loss from the disease. Wet AMD attempts to promote the growth of abnormal leaky retinal vessels, which tend to break, bleed, and leak fluid into the retina, causing localized detachments and thus rapidly leading to severe vision loss. The disease progression of the wet AMD is therefore very rapid and patient-specific, which makes an early diagnosis and treatment crucial for preserving vision. For the assessment of the AMD, the optical coherence tomography is used as standard imaging modality. OCT generates image volumes of the retina composed of non-adjacent 2D cross-sectional images, also called B-scans. A B-scan of an AMD patient is shown on both images. Morphological OCT-based biomarkers such as fluid accumulations, which are highlighted in yellow, red, and green in the right image, as well as the retinal thickness, which can be calculated from the difference between the upper and the lower retinal boundaries, are used as treatment indicators. The monitoring of the AMD is regulated by treatment schemes. These schemes require that the disease status of each patient is assessed at regular intervals. This requires a visit to the eye clinic, where the physician uses OCT to decide whether treatment is necessary or not. However, the examination intervals of current treatment schemes are too long and not adapted to patient-specific recurrence patterns. Shorter examination intervals would allow for an early start of a treatment, but at the same time cause a high burden for the mostly elderly patients and also high personal costs. Thus, a high monitoring frequency can realistically only be achieved by a home monitoring solution, for example by an OCT device at the patient's home. In a home monitoring scenario, patients can independently assess their current disease status without the presence of a physician. The image data would then be sent to the clinic, where it is analyzed by the physician. The physician then informs the patient whether a treatment is necessary or not. However, the expected large amount of image data, especially if, for example, an image is generated every day, can no longer be evaluated manually by the medical staff. For this reason, computer-aided diagnosis of the OCT image data is required, which automatically detects pathology changes and notifies both the patient and the physician so that further steps can be taken. Such a novel concept for self-examination, low-cost, full-field OCT, with the acronym SELF-OCT, was developed by our colleagues at the Medical Laser Center. The SELF-OCT is a cost-effective and compact OCT device and is currently being tested in clinical trials. In the following, I will briefly introduce the main features of the SELF-OCT. In contrast to established clinical OCTs such as the Heidelberg Spectralis, which produces non-adjacent cross-sectional images of the retina, the SELF-OCT acquires transversal on fast images at different depths, resulting in a densely sampled volume. This is illustrated in the left and middle figure. Furthermore, it can be seen that the field of view of the self-velocity is much smaller than that of the Heidelberg Spectralis. However, it is sufficient to assess the AMD. A size comparison of the field of views is shown in the right figure. Now we will come to the visual impression of the self-OCT in comparison to a clinic OCT. On the left you can see a B-scan of a Heidelberg Spectralis OCT and on the right a B-scan of the self-OCT of the same AMD patient. Comparing both scans, one notices the significant different image impression. Due to the very cost-effective and compact optical design, images of the self-OCT show a lower signal-to-noise ratio and specific artifacts. In the following, I will explain the two prominent of them. Here I will present moving and saturation artifacts as examples. Axial movements of the head during the scanning process lead to the deletion of entire slices, which result in light to severe stripes in the scan. Additionally, image areas above and below such stripes may be shifted against each other. Furthermore, saturation artifacts can considerably disturb the evaluability of the scan. These appear by some vertical streaks that in the worst case appear as some prominent black stripes. For an automatic evaluation of the self-OCT image data, we developed in this work a deep learning-based segmentation algorithm. We segmented two structures in the self-OCT image data, the total retina volume and the pigment epithelial detachments, which are called in the following PED. Both are relevant OCT-based AMD biomarkers. Additionally, we integrated anatomical prior knowledge into the approach to make the segmentation process more robust against artifacts. Our approach consists of two main components, segmentation and shape refinement. In the segmentation part, the self-OCT volume is pre-segmented by a unit. The segmentation is then binarized and transferred to an autoencoder. The autoencoder performs a shape refinement to correct possible segmentation errors caused by image artifacts. Lastly, the unit segmentation is merged with the refined retina shape of the autoencoder to obtain the final segmentation. In the following, I will describe the segmentation and the shape refinement in more detail. Due to the densely sampled volumes of the self-OCT, the 3D unit architecture was a natural choice. To address the high class label imbalance, we used the generalized dice loss proposed by Sudre et al. Furthermore, we performed augmentations like horizontal flips, similarity transforms, and nonlinear intensity shifts to avoid overfitting. In order to make the method robust against image interference such as weak SNR and artifacts, we use prior anatomical knowledge in the form of a convolutional denoising autoencoder. Autoencoders learn sparse intermediate representation of the input and can reconstruct then the input from this representation again. In addition, denoising autoencoders reconstruct the original input from noisy images. As input, the CDAE receives the binarized segmentation of the unit and thus learns the retinal shape. The same training scheme is used as for the unit, whereby we used the binarized ground truth segmentation as input. To simulate segmentation errors, we performed further augmentations such as adding binary noise, elastic deformations, and adding or removing ellipsoids. Here you can see three example augmentations. The dataset used in this work was generated during the self-OCT pilot study. It comprises 711 image volumes of eyes of 44 patients in total. Of these, 53 eyes had AMD and 12 had a similar disease. 7 eyes were healthy. The ground truth was manually generated by a medical expert, where only every 5th B-scan was annotated to keep the work within a visible scope. In addition, we pre-processed the image volumes by smoothening them and adjusting the lateral dimensions through resampling. For the evaluation, we compared the segmentation of the unit with the refined ones of the CDAE. For this purpose, we performed a five-fold cross-validation. For each fault, we divided the data set into training, validation, and test data set, and also ensured that the disease distribution of the eyes remained the same. For the evaluation, we used the following metrics: the dye similarity coefficient, the average symmetric surface distance, and the Hausdorff distance. In the following, I present the qualitative and the quantitative results. The first qualitative result shows a retina with a large PD area. One can easily see that two prominent motion artifacts, which are marked by the white arrows, led to a corrupt unit segmentation. These errors were corrected by the CDAE refinement. In the second qualitative result, the upper part of the retina is very difficult to detect due to the weak image contrast. This area is also marked by a white arrow. In the unit segmentation, the weak contrast led to an edge in the retinal surface, which was subsequently repaired by the CDE refinement. The quantitative results are shown in the following table. The retina could be segmented with high accuracy with a dye overlap of almost 0.94, whereas the segmentation of PD areas was more challenging. Here a dye of about 0.6 could be achieved. Furthermore, the average symmetric surface distance and the Hausdorff distance were calculated to investigate the effect of the CDAE refinement. The average symmetric surface distance of the CDAE segmentation increased slightly compared to the unit, which can be explained by the smoothing properties of the autoencoders. In contrast, the Hausdorff distance has been slightly reduced by the CDAE refinement, which indicates a reduction of outliers. However, one can notice that the quantitative difference between the unit and the CDAE refinement is very small. In conclusion, in this work, a deep learning-based method for segmentation of low-cost OCT image data was presented for the first time. We could show that the retina can already be segmented with a high accuracy, whereas the segmentation of PD structures is still challenging. In future work, we intend to improve the segmentation accuracy for PED to reach the same performance level as current state-of-the-art methods, which achieve a dye between 0.7 and 0.8 for PED in clinical OCT image data. Finally, unfortunately, we could only show the CDAE refinement qualitatively. In the meantime, the self-OCT has been further developed. An improved patient interface could reduce the motion artifacts, and an advanced optical design increases the SNR. The improvement in image quality can be clearly seen in the two figures. However, analysis of the image data remains challenging. Finally, the size of the technical components of the self-OCT has been reduced so that it now fits into a handheld device, just right for a home monitoring application. For further information, you can have a look at our SPE paper on archive, which you can access via the QR code. Thank you very much.